Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to Rainbow Moon Post Game. Now, we're going to take on the final side quest for our Jade Statues today, and we need to get at least 15 within the remaining dungeons that we need to yet explore. So, what we're going to do today is start off here at Zrah's camp. So what we'll do is just go ahead and head up to the barrier, which is just over here. I can get by the little man trailer. Let's see, we've got a couple of enemies in here, so I'll just go ahead and clear them all out. I'm going to try and take at least as much as I can today, just so I can sell it later on. I will take them. They'll come in handy for boosting. Two Jade Statues. Okay, 13 more to go. Another two, excellent. So now we only need another 11. I will take all that. Well, I think we're pretty much done here. This. Okay guys, I'm going to go ahead and find us another dungeon to explore, so I'll be right back. Okay guys, I am currently here in Dripstone Cave. Now what you're going to do is head on into this area, and there are going to be some vampire lords in here that you need to clear out. I will take them. And once you've done each section, you have to pull the switches so you can gain access into the next little area. So you are going to be battling for at least a good 10 minutes. Now the first switch is here, so once you've pulled that, it allows you to go into all the other areas. And I haven't bothered to kill him. But then what you're going to do is come over and pull this switch. And then pull this switch. And that lets you into the centre. But if you come here, click on this, we have a rainbow medal. So now let's see what we've got. Another two Jade Statues. So we're doing well. And when you come into this section, you're going to have another couple of enemies to sort of take care of. Nothing too difficult. So we'll just make our way through all the orbs. Basically just pick the ones that are sort of behind the boxes. And it takes us here. Now we do have a switch up here to pull, which will open the door to where the chests are around here. Just make sure there's nothing hidden. Nope. Take all them. And it's just another couple of vampire lords that are sort of wandering around in here as well. Another two jade statues. And rainbow bars. So we've now got five statues in total from this area. Let's just continue on and see what else we've got. And that just takes us back out again. I've already pulled these switches which let us into this next area. Now when you come into this section you're going to have vampire lords guarding all of these chests. I'm just going to go ahead and empty them all out. There we go. Now if you actually come over here, you're going to be confronted by a group of level 800 banned pages. Now you don't have to take on the battle, but I've already done it just so I could see what was ahead. So what I'm going to do guys is just go and save my game and I'll be right back. Okay, let's just go through the orb. Now I have already taken care of one or two of the groups of enemies. And I've left these two groups of banned pages just because there's a bit more enemies in them than I'd like to take care of for the moment. And I've already opened up two of the chests. They only contained rainbow snacks, so I would assume that's what's behind the other chests. But if you come up here, there's actually a switch to pull, which opens that gate at the side entrance. But other than that, I think we're pretty much done here. So we've got at least all our five statues, so let's just now head back to the entrance. Now I have seen this level 999 guy just wandering about. That was why we actually pulled the switch in that other room, so it lets us in here anytime we wish. But for the moment guys, I'm going to go ahead and find us another dungeon to explore. So I'll be right back. Okay guys, let's just head into our third area now. And we're here at Endless Passage once again, and if you see from our map here we have quite a few magic fields that we need to sort of pass through. So what I'm going to do guys is make my way through the area once again and I'll just sort of cut in between each magic field, so I'll see you guys there. Okay, field number one. Make sure there's nothing in between these boxes. I will take them, why not? Take them. Field number two. I will take it all. I'll just be selling it all anyway. Field number three. I'll take the money. want to watch my inventory space at the moment. Field number 4. Sure, there's nothing hidden around all these edges. Take them. Jade statue. There's only one of them, but it's better than none. So this is where it's sort of hidden. Not too far into the dungeon. Field number 5. Take all that. Take them as well. So we've done quite a bit of this area so far. We're halfway through. Field number 6. Nothing really of any value here. Let's make our way over to the other magic field that's pretty close here. Magic field number 7. Another jade statue. So that's our second one in here. And we'll just bring up our map. So it's pretty close to where the other one was. But let's continue on. Magic field number 8. Nothing here. Field number 9. Take the money. Take all that. Now, there are a lot of these orbs here, but there's no secret area or anything. I've sort of tried to go through as many as possible, and they'll just sort of take me towards the end, which is here. Another jade statue, third of the area, which is not exactly hard to miss. So we've only got a couple of more fields to pass through it. So let's continue on. Field number 10. Money. Okay, nothing of any value here. Well, the other magic field isn't that far away, so we can easily just walk over to it very quickly. Okay, magic field number 11. I just want to double check, nothing in these other corners? Nope. Another jade statue. Take all that as well. So we've now got four from this area. And we have one more field to pass through. Our last magic field. So let's see what we have. Money. Food items which we don't need. There we go. So we've now managed to clear out all the magic fields in here. We've gathered four jade statues. We now have 13 in total. So we need to find another two more. So what I'm going to do, guys, is go ahead and find us another area to explore, and I'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back at Castle Temwall once again, so let's just head on in. And let's see, we have to go up this way. Now the last time we came in here, if you remember, we already took down this magic wall, but we weren't ready to take care of the level 500 dark mages, so I'm just going to go off screen and take care of them all, and I'll be right back. Okay, so what we're going to do is just step on this little magic panel here to let us into the centre. Now you can pull this lever if you wish, you don't have to. And we'll take all them. Now, in between each of these little grooves are dark mages. But that switch we pulled opens up the gate behind this vampire lord, but we don't actually have to go that way. But if you pull this lever, it opens up this gate here beside the healer. But we're going to head up here. And in between each of these bags are dark mages, which are optional if you wish to choose to fight them. And we'll just take all the money. I'm quite happy to take it all. Now there are groups of around 12 to 13 mages blocking each of these bags. Nothing too difficult. There we go. Now that just leaves this chest. Two jade statues, big mouse, and a rainbow bar stack. Okay, so we've now got all 15 jade statues that we need, so I'm just going to head back to Krylo so we can go ahead and turn these in. Hello, Mr. Krylo, we're back. And yes, we have all 15. And you're giving us even more money. Ah, and two rainbow bars. Fair enough. Side quest complete. Okay, so what we're going to do now is just have a little look at what items we now have.
Actual service.
Eternal Annihilator Plus, which I have plenty of money to buy. Marksman's Tide Plus. plus. Twist of Fate and Twist of Fate plus. And Legacy of Light plus. That's fair enough. A couple of things there I do need to buy, which I will get at a later time. Back again. Now, armour. Dragon Scale Armour plus, which will be helpful. 100,000 HP. Biting Hunter Suit plus. Evil Crusher Shroud plus. Lizard's Eye Hat plus. Righteous Gift. Ah, massive HP boost, which will come in very handy for everybody. So that'll have to get bought. And that's pretty much everything. That's fair enough. So guys, we've now finally managed to gain all our Jade statues and receive all our rewards. In the next episode, I'm hoping to try and find all the rainbow medals and show you guys what rewards you'll get for that. But in the meantime, thank you very much for watching, and I shall see you all again next time.